get some seats situated here before I get aggravated.
You guys are in this interview.
Is this the one where we're saying fuck all the time?
You ask him, he's the director on that.
Hey,
it wasn't my idea.
I tell you.
How many chairs do we need?
Vocabulary. We wouldn't have anything to say, would we?
Hey, man, you know us long haired rock and rollers, man.
Yeah.
Fuck up.
You're almost as old as I am, so fuck, I know.
Well, me? I'm 16.
Yeah, I'm only.
Minutes.
We don't like each other enough to
fuck. This is the same thing with my band. Yeah, I get the same problem. Are you rolling?
If it wasn't for getting dressed in the J change, we
Hey, I'm Asa for Genovese, reporting for the gate, and we are here with Brighton Rock.
How's it going?
Say hi.
Birdie.
Say who you are.
Stevie Screeves. Am I still the bass player? I'm the bass player of the band.
Tonight he is, and I'm Jerry McGee. I'm the lead singer.
Okay. Hey, Frage, get over here. We got a dual person here.
Billy Ray Frage.
Okay.
Billy Ray Seagal.
There he is. Greg Fraser, also in...
Scurvy Dogs.
And
what band are we?
Brighton Rock.
Okay, right. And Helix.
There you go.
Man of all bands.
So, why don't you guys tell me what's going on with the band right now?
We're getting ready to do a show here at Front 54 in Thorold. I don't know why you weren't here. But we're getting ready to do some new tunes and do some new recording and
see
what happens.
Jerry's looking for some stage clothes.
That's right. I left my shorts at home. I can't believe it.
Got any tentative names for songs
coming
on?
Still too early, yeah. Still piecing it together. That'll be done mostly all next month.
I see.
Then we'll see how it shapes up and see where it's going from that point. Mm-hmm. We never like to plan anything. Because plans never work out.
So this guy's been missing rehearsal. Tell me about that.
Well, actually, we get a lot more done when Jerry's not there.
Yeah, I confuse them. They don't like to hear me sing.
It's
so they
a
don't
distraction,
put it in
actually.
Yeah.
Actually, throughout the whole years of the band, Jerry's probably only been to about 5 rehearsals, and we get a lot more done.
But I was there for the big ones.
Yeah.
Five rehearsals, and all the time.
Maybe, even that. So, like, we get a lot more work done without Jerry there.
Plus, it just lets you know
who really does all the work in the band, you know what I mean?
This is the brains behind the band.
Yeah.
A lot of brains.
So you can see why we're in the situation we're in now.
So what are you guys playing now? I mean, as far as the band, what kind of material can you hope
we're
to expect?
We're going like back from the first album and cover all three albums and just do like a greatest hits type of version of
and
everything.
And fun ones.
Yeah.
Songs that are fun to do. So hopefully they like it as much as we like playing.
Yeah. You know, we're not going to please everybody because everybody wants to hear something else. So we're just going to do what we think everybody wants to hear, and you know, like our favorite tunes of the month.
What's the newer stuff sounding like? I mean, is it pretty much the same format as your older stuff, or is it changing with
kinda
the times?
Kind of right now. It's not going to be changing with the times because that's not us.
Right.
So what we do is we just get in and we lay it all down, and we'll pick the best 10 out of 20. But it'll be us, so it'll show what we grew up listening to and what you listen to now. There'll be little influences, but we're not going to be a grunge band. We're not going to try and
still
metal jam. We're not.
Roll at its finest.
And we're going to try and keep a lot of melody, have a lot of party rock as far as, you know, the old chug make you want to go and drink music. So that's what we're about. That's what kind of band we are. That's what the material will be like.
You want to talk about your record deal? What happened with that? I mean, you guys were signed for a while.
We broke up so that we could get released. We got released after, actually, we're still not technically released legally. But verbally, we're released.
You weren't happy with what was going on?
No, it was a very political situation, and nothing we really want to point any fingers at, but it was just, you know, we weren't happy. And,
it was time to go each other's ways. Yeah. They were good to us for a while, and we were good for them for a while, so it worked out good, and we made some good friends, but that's not the way we want to do it now.
There was a change of the guard at the record company, and the people that were behind us when we got signed were no longer there, and like, you know, just like anything else, you need that support.
Right.
When those people weren't there, we needed them, so it's just time to move on.
Yeah.
And we'll be patient until we get the next deal. Like, we're not going to sign with anybody who wants us. We want to make sure there's a commitment there from the label to make
We've
it
made
work.
The mistakes.
Yeah.
Right.
So now we know
now you know what to do.
Unfortunately, sometimes it takes some years to do it.
Right.
But when you're young and you're eager, you don't turn down a chance to sign with a major label, right?
Right,
you think a lot of things can change, but you can also see a lot of stuff that they don't do. that Hungry Laborers will do. And we had to go through that in order to come to this point now where we know what we want. Whether they want to deal with us is another thing, but we know what we want, we know how we want to do it. So it makes it a little bit more focused than what it was before. And reality, a lot more realistic than what you are when you first get in. You figure, once you sign the big record deal, the limo rolls up and so does the vault.
Right.
Money in it.
Right.
The work
it ain't, ain't that.
The bottom line is, it's a business. And when you're young, you really don't realize it's a business.
You don't want to think about that.
And if you close your eyes to it, you're going to get swallowed up and eaten.
Right.
Really.
You're more concerned about living your dream.
Yeah.
And you got a shot at living your dream, something you always wanted.
Guys, I know exactly
what
you're talking
about. It's sad, but it's true. It's not just
the best
bands or the best songs always make it. It's a very political business.
Yeah.
And, what, you waving? Hi.
Hi, it's just said five.
Oh, five.
Oh.
Yeah, there's five guys in the band. What are you trying to tell us?
Two here.
I hope you ain't saying there's five people out there.
Are you saying what?
So too.
There's 500 people
500
out there.
People out there?
There's 500.
Oh, right. And the place only seats 100? Right on.
All right.
Right on. Hey, that's what we're used to.
And they're not Pittsburgh fans.
Ah.
No Pittsburgh.
Don't give
they're
that.
They're all in jail. Man.
Don't give that bum any airtime.
No Miami fans.
So, you have any prospective labels that you're going for right now?
First thing is the band. Before we even want to, we don't want to talk to management. We don't want to talk to labels.
Right.
We got to sit and see where we feel everything's going to go, and if we still like it where it's going.
Yeah.
So the only way that happens is us getting together and working it out. When we go to see people, we're going to have something to show them. Not old albums.
Right.
Not old laurels. This is what the band's doing now. Is that interesting? And that's the best way to do it rather than plugging it out.
Really quick, though, have the industry been kind of poking around at you guys saying, hey, are you ready yet? Are you ready yet?
No, because I don't think a lot of them know where we are. We've stayed so low-key that I don't think we spoke with people at our label that are still friends that ask, but we've never said that anything's been happening, and we'd rather keep it that way.
But
we'd
overseas, rather, there's been a little interest.
Yeah, in places that we did well in Europe, we've shown it there, but we've kind of said, look, we want to piece this together our way and see how we feel about it.
It's got to be right.
Yeah.
It's got to be right before we put our life on the line.
When you come out again, would you rather come out overseas or rather make of it here again?
Wherever the commitment is.
Yeah, wherever we know they're going to give it a shot and we can really make a good run at it and have fun doing it. That's what
I don't
want to
play any games this time.
Yeah.
You know, whoever lays their cards on the table and shows up the right cards, they're the ones that are going to get the band, and that's the way it's going to work.
Yeah.
We're not going to go down knocking on doors. We're going to talk to people, and the ones that want to work with us, hey, they're the ones that are going to work with the band,
we'll
know?
We'll take it that way.
Right. And we'll be patient enough to wait for that.
Hopefully not too long.
Yeah, we still got our hair, so we're okay.
Yeah, we're not going bald or anything.
No. I got the old receding hairline going on, man.
Yeah.
So, all right, well, I guess we'll call that a wrap. Oh, one last thing.
Yeah.
Brighton Rock is going to do some shows with Ace in a Hole in the future.
That sounds like a plan,
Be
Ace.
A good one.
All right.
Okay, a good one.
Okay, we're reporting from the gate. Say Merry Christmas, guys.
Merry Christmas,
everybody.
Have
See
a good
ya.
One. Yeah.
we gotta put in half a day. But screw all that shit, man. It's Christmas time. Let's get the place rocking. Let's get the place drinking. Let's bring in 95 real good. We're gonna continue with some more Love Machine stuff right now.
Yeah.
which was the first Brighton Rock record called Young, Wild, and Free. The first thing that probably most of you have seen in the band, and kind of became our trademark for a little while. See if you can guess this one. Mr. Billy,
Thank you. Thank you.